I'm John Daniel and you're watching Street Vibes. Today the African descendants like myself share our sentiments on African Liberation Day.
African Liberation Day. Africa can never be truly free until all Africans are free, at home and abroad. Big up the diaspora. Mutabaruka say, give me back me this, give me back me that, give me everything you got. Give me gold, give me diamond, give me everything you take and you have up in your museum. Give me back. So African Liberation Day, reparation, sin? No. All what the thief, all what they have stuck up, all the jewels, all the artifacts, all what they have in their museums making how much money offer. Give me back. France, all what France thief, still thiefing, all what England thief, still thiefing. Bring it back.
So my thoughts on Liberation Day, I think it's a day that we as people of African descent should look at ourselves and reflect on the journey that doesn't start from slavery, but go beyond slavery, go before slavery, before the times of biblical times, like go beyond that, try to keep going beyond to find the information that is out there about our people, about ourselves, about the DNA that runs through our body, to know the greatness that we come from and stop looking at our history from how we are learned to think in the Bible or slavery or in the social study books in our curriculum in school.
As far as the Africans, I like what's going on right now. The Africans now are learning the history, or matter of fact, I think they're trying to find themselves as real African people, and they're trying to even teach the younger generation about the slave trade and stuff like that. So now we are trying to get to know ourselves, and we are trying to build for a better future for our young ones and stuff like that. But I gather that the Europeans and the white people are more trying to take over us and try to enslave us. But we are picking up now and we are getting wiser, and we are trying to educate our own selves so that we will know our own history.
My comment on the African Liberation Day, I don't think we have much to do with that. And how much it will impact on us in whatever way, I don't see the connection as such. It's true, I understand the understanding that we are black people and we are somewhere connected to Africa and the whole history and so on. But at the same time, when you've been specific as to African Liberation Day, that don't have much to do with us, you know. I really don't think so.
Well, to me, what I see, Africa, for me, Africa don't have no Liberation Day, because Africans haven't liberated themselves as yet. You understand? I got a young boy knowing United States of America, I never heard United States of Africa as yet. You understand? I don't think Africa has been liberated as yet. Understand?
Same kind of African liberation thing there. And not on that, you know. You hear me? With 2022, them black and white fighting thing, it's pure magic. African Liberation Day. I not on that.
African Liberation Day was established 59 years ago on the 25th of May 1963, when the Organization of African Unity was launched at the United Nations. And it was a historic occasion when Emperor Haile Selassie, as the first chair of the Organization of African Unity, delivered a very historic speech that everybody knows and has heard, but just doesn't know that it was a speech by Haile Selassie. And I'm speaking here of a song that should be the theme song today, yesterday, and tomorrow. And that is the song called War by Bob Marley and the Wailers. Until, you know, the color of a man's skin is of no more significance than the color of his eyes. That was an anthem indicating that African liberation would continue to be fought for beyond independence for as long as racism existed.
We reflect on Africa as our black people descendants, and for the continent, as Bob Marley says, divide and rule keeps tearing us apart. an internal power struggle amongst the leaders. But Africa is rich in resources, gold, fish, timber. But the big corporations from Europe and America keep robbing Africa of taxes, understating the profits, and in the pride, some of the leaders, a few millions, and the African continent suffers. People, let's get together, raise our consciousness, and Caribbean people, don't forget our homeland. We took the task from our African heritage. I'm proud. Black to be proud, proud to be black. And with that, we take you back to our studio.